morning, guys. I am Patty Elhoff, the author of Upcycle with Decoupage. And today I'm going to show you how to make this. And if you look in the description of this video that you're watching, there will be a link right to my blog where it not only lists all of the products that you'll need, you'll also be able to click on those links and purchase them. This all goes through Amazon, so if you're on Amazon Prime, you qualify for all of those same benefits. I know some of you have been going through my website to get your supplies, and I really appreciate that. So if you do not have one of these Patron bottles, you can use any bottle that you would like. And if you like the liquor bottle, some of the liquor bottles are quite beautiful. You can go to a restaurant that you normally frequent and ask, or if you have a waitress, waiter, or especially a bartender friend, these bottles end up in the trash or in the recycling. Ask if you can either go through some of their recycling or if a friend of yours can just take one of the empty, make sure they're empty bottles, and give them to you. This looks like it has a frosted finish, and I was very excited to work on it. But look what happened when I put Mod Podge over it. It cleared the glass right out. So I'm going to show you how to do a faux finish. So I'm mixing gloss Mod Podge, and I added about 2 heaping tablespoons of this into the Mod Podge, and I stirred it up. Did some experimenting and found out that the best way to apply this Mod Podge to the bottle so that you get a nice faux finish is to use a roller brush. A sponge brush was used on the glass on the left, and the roller brush was used on the glass on the right. Now, while your bottles are drying, here's what I did. I found this video on YouTube where this girl made the most beautiful snowflakes. The video is about 7 minutes long. The link is in the description of this video. You may have your own way to make snowflakes, but I thought the way this girl showed them was so simple and they came out so pretty that I went over and started to cut some following the instructions on the video step by step. It's actually very simple. There's just one thing I would add to her video. She is using scissors like this, you know, the larger scissors. If you do any decoupage at all, you really want to have these smaller scissors on hand. They're curved. They get into these tiny little patterns. They seem to always be sharp as long as you only use them on paper. This is decorative paper. I also did it on coffee filters. I also did it on doilies. I messed up a little bit here. And the pretty thing about the doilies is it's already got some intricate work around the outside. We're going to decoupage them on the bottle. And the other thing that you have to be careful of is the surface of your bottle. You want to make sure the snowflake fits where you're going to put it because the bottle is only so big. She recommends using copy paper. I just made everything a lot smaller, and you definitely would want scissors like this if you're using the smaller pattern. Now the bottle's dry. There is our faux frosted finish. And because this is so delicate, I watered the Mod Podge down a little bit. This is a coffee filter, and you can see how tiny this was. It was a little difficult to cut. I could have gone a little bit larger. And you may want to paint your coffee filters before you add these on. I'm just sticking with the white because I'm going to add some glitter over top. But I watered the Mod Podge down because the coffee filters are so absorbent. I applied it right on over our dried surface. Place this down carefully, and again, because it's so delicate, you want to be careful. I'm taking a piece of saran wrap, just like when we decoupage with napkins, and I'm pressing that down, pulling it down around the bottle. This way I can press the snowflake down. Don't have to worry about tearing it or ripping it. Plastic doesn't stick to the bottle or to the snowflake. I'm going to let this side dry and then I'm going to do the other side. This is a different bottle, obviously, but just make sure you always use a clean piece of saran wrap as you go around the bottle. Per snowflake, you'll want a fresh sheet of the saran wrap. Now that everything is dry, I'm going to put a coat of decoupage glue, the Mod Podge, over the whole bottle. I'm going to seal it all over again. Then I'm going to let it dry. Now you have to make sure your bottle is dry, completely dry, before this next step. Because what we're going to do is actually take some craft glue on the tip of this tiny brush, and we're just going to paint it right on the snowflake, just on the snowflake, and then we're going to put glitter on it. Something else you can also do is place a stencil over. I have this larger one, and for some reason the center looks more like an Aztec pattern, not a snowflake. So I happen to have some snowflake stencils. I'm just going to put this one in the center, and I'm going to put glue inside the stencil, and then I'm going to also accent the edges with the glue. Once everything dried, I took this Mod Podge Gloss Luster Clear Acrylic Sealer, and I wanted to make sure it was gloss, and I sprayed it over both of the bottles, and you can see on the bottle on the right, it does not dull the glitter at all. And I also took the top, which is cork, and I just added glue, craft glue, to the whole thing and rolled it in glitter. And I did that a couple of times. I wanted to give it a look kind of like a snowball. So if there's one thing that I could suggest, it does look like it's a little bit hard to see the snowflakes on the background. And I was going for a snowy look. However, the snowflakes are so light you can hardly see them, which is a shame because the snowflake on that bottle actually looks really pretty, but it's very hard to see with that background. So you may want to do something to bring out the contrast, which would either mean a light background with a dark snowflake or a darker background with a lighter snowflake. And that's our video for today. Thank you so much for subscribing. If you've got any questions, send me a message at the bottom of this video. I will be back next week with another video. And if you want to reuse these bottles for liquor, wine, whatever you'd like to use them for, just make sure you put a little bit of olive oil around the inside rim so that when you spray it, the spray will not get inside the bottle. And the same with the cork. I did not finish the bottom because I don't want any of that glitter to get on there. And once you put the top coat over this, it stays on. You don't have any worries, so nothing's going to come off in the food or the drink. But I would not put these in the dishwasher. You can definitely use a warm, damp cloth to clean them off. And in the meantime, guys, I hope you have a wonderful holiday. I'll be back next week with another video for you. And thanks again. Bye-bye.